The idea came about because when I was doing, on June 8th of 88, I was doing a commercial at the racetrack, and there was a blonde woman, and then there was a white gentleman on the other side, and we were supposed to be cheering in the stands. So we're cheering, and then halfway through the day, the director says, well, I need to switch the girl and the guy, so the guy is next to me. So I asked him, I said, why did you do that? And he said, well, the client said, we don't want you to be next to the blonde woman because they may think you're together. So I thought, gee, my dad's white, my dad's black, and my mom's white. I didn't think of it. I grew up that way. It's not a big deal. But so I thought, how can I make a change in society? How can I make it that this is the norm? It looks, we can all live, work, and play together. So that was really the impetus for the idea of the show. It was not as much about fitness, but it was about trying to change people's attitudes.
And I think what was also very important, especially to me, is that women were shown on television to be equals. Often back in the 1980s, when the aerobics craze was on, you would see, you know, the it was all, one more, two more, and, you know, we're not all like that. Or there was a television show on CNN where there was this big, hefty guy, Jay, it was Body by Jake, and he would have the very petite, blonde female who was doing the exercises for him. And it was important for me that women are portrayed as equals in what we do athletically. We are equal hosts, and that people, you can work together. So that was also something that was part of getting BodyBreak together.
Yeah, I'd like to be an equal host, but Joanne actually writes the scripts and she does all, yeah. So she gets all the good stuff. I get the leftovers.